Well, it's time to take a look at Stonehenge, and there are many theories regarding this unusual organization of stones, about who built it, and why or how, but unfortunately nobody really knows, and personally, I don't really like theories, unless they happen to be my own, but fortunately I don't have any theories regarding Stonehenge, so instead, what we're going to do is simply look at the stones and the ground around it in order to discern valuable pieces of understanding. And we're going to focus on how to image the world, because when you look at Stonehenge, it's a vivid depiction of how the mind is to create an image that will build a glorious kingdom. This begins by mirroring your world. When you think of Stonehenge, you consider walking up to it, and it's mesmerizing. You just stare at it. It looks wondrous, but why is it so captivating? Because it's a circle. And what does a circle look like? The Earth. The Earth is a circle. So when we look at Stonehenge, we feel like maybe we'll get secret knowledge about the big circle through the little circle. And technically, this is correct. The little circle is supposed to be an expression of the big circle. That's how things naturally work, because in your mind, you're supposed to make a little circle for your kingdom that's supposed to express the big circle, which is Earth, this earthly kingdom, all this wonder and glory. It's supposed to be encompassed in your little circle within your mind. So when you make the image for your kingdom, use a circle, because that's how the world understands. That's how the world works already. Make an image for your kingdom as a circle. Then you must break down your circle. You must mark the end for your kingdom. So when you look at Stonehenge, there's the stones in the center, but look at that interesting circle that's made of a ditch around that. This is a very helpful depiction of what you're supposed to do in your mind. In your mind, you're supposed to mark the end, the ultimate expansion of your kingdom. But that's the end. Remember, the warriors are all about the end, but you need to mark that end. The warriors need to be able to see through your mental image what you want them to conquer for you. But when you initially build your image, you don't fill the whole space, you just mark the end, how big you want it to become, and then you need to focus on the beginning. And the beginning is what you manifest in your mind. And in Stonehenge, they are the stones, this little circle inside the bigger circle. And in your mind, for your kingdom, you must consider, what buildings do I need? What people do I need? Do I need cars? Do I need music? What do I need for my kingdom? And then you must all picture that inside your mind, and then have it within a larger encompassing area. How big do you want this to get? And if your inner beginning, all those buildings and those people and that cool mental image you have, like Stonehenge in the middle, if that's inspiring, wizards will come to you and they'll be like, wow, how can I help you fill this expansive space? How can I make your mental image come into fruition? And then warriors will come along and they'll think, well, what can I do? How big do you want this to be? And you need to mark it out for them. But you need that beginning. You need to have that manifested concept of the buildings. Do you need an education center? Do you need a place for people to gather and meet and teach? What do you need that's going to feed this expansion? You have to make it ready for the warriors and the wills as they come to join you. But there is one thing still missing. If you look at all these people, where are they? Well, they're on the side, kind of looking at Stonehenge and all of it, but where are they not? They're not inside the stones. Why? Because everybody innately knows they don't belong there. They don't belong at the center of the circle. They don't belong as the epicenter of this wondrous ancient creation. The individual who belongs there is long dead. But within your mind, you must place yourself as the ruler in the center. These stones in the ground and the ditch have no power by themselves. Even the thought in your head doesn't have power. The power flows through you. You're a spiritual creator, a soul with a physical body. You must keep yourself at the center of the beginning of all the buildings and the people and everything you need to start your glorious kingdom, and keep that at the center of your glorious end that you desire. You must be the centerpiece. because all the power that's going to enable this kingdom to come from your mind, out through your heart, out through your body, and into the world in partnership with other wizards, warriors, and wills, all of that power comes through you. So, when you image the world as the will, mentally image your kingdom as concentric circles around you.